What is the World Jewish Congress?
World Jewish Congress is the umbrella organization that represents all the Jewish communities worldwide. There are more than 100 Jewish communities in more than 100 countries, and the heads of the communities are part of our world, and we represent the communities, and the communities represent us in the countries where Jews live.
And you are the CEO. So what is it to like manage the whole world Jewry?
I'm very new in this job. Before I came to World Jewish Congress, I was the CEO of World Org, which is also a very big international organization.
Yes, sir.
With more than 60 countries. So, but now what we are doing now in this position, we're representing the Jewish communities on the political level. So we're representing them towards different governments, the international institutions, and it's like you said, it's to represent the world Jewry in every place where Jews live.
And what is your work in Israel?
In Israel we have one of our offices. We have many offices in different parts of the world. One of our offices is in Israel. And our work is to connect with the Jewish communities and the Israeli government, the Knesset, and the Israeli society. So members of our Israeli board are either members of the parliament, Knesset, or public figures. So we have many projects together. For example, now one of the new big projects is Hasbara on campuses. I know that you don't have such a big problem here, but Jewish students in Europe today, and in South Africa and some other places, have very serious problems. I just explained yesterday during the dinner to the presidents of your communities, a few examples. For example, what is happening in Brussels, what's happening in Scotland, where Jewish students feel very uncomfortable on the campuses. So we start now a new program of Hasbara campuses, and we are using the Israeli infrastructure also to get from them the information and the knowledge about what's happening.
You spoke about Bulgaria, Greece, but what are the other red flags in the world now?
Well, I think from the point of view of neo-Nazi political movements, because it's a big difference. It's not just some group; it's a political movement. It's political parties who are legitimately represented in the parliament of these countries, and are growing. In Hungary today, 16%. Of the parliament are members of a party called Jobbik, which is clearly anti-Semitic and neo-Nazi party. In, as I said, in Bulgaria, I think it's around today around 9%. In Ukraine, it's more than 10%. In Greece, I don't remember the percentage, but it's also more or less around these numbers. So the problem is really the political activities. The other big problem of the red flag is the relation to the Muslim population in many countries and the Jewish population, and also the influence, the political influence of Muslims in these countries. About 10% of the French population today are Muslim who immigrated from different countries. In cities like Brussels, about 30% of the population, which is the center of Europe, the capital of the European Union, 30% of the population in Brussels today are Muslims. So I'm not all of them are extremists, but it created new realities that Jewish communities have to deal with.
What is the impression you had from our president? What were the results of the talks?
We were very impressed, really very, very impressed, and we meet the heads of the states all the time. Almost every week we meet the different prime minister or president. I think that all of us left your president's office today very impressed, both from him personally as a person and his way of really seeing things and his strategies, but also regarding his relationship with the Jewish community. here and his position towards Israel. So I think all of us left the room with a very good feeling and with a very positive impression.
And would you like to say a message to the Jewish community here?
The message to the Jewish community is that you are one of the best I ever saw, and really I travel the world all the time. I think you have an excellent community with excellent Jewish institutions, and we have a lot to learn from you. The only message: be more proactive, more not only at home, not only inside the communities, but also outside the communities. And I think you can help us a lot.